He wasn't a doctor or a scientist, just a father staring helplessly at his dying child. Doctors had diagnosed the child with a rare genetic condition, Menkes disease, a condition with a 100% chance of death for boys. The recommendation? Ease his pain and prepare for the end. But this father, armed with nothing more than a high school education, refused to accept that. He believed the nation's medical experts were wrong. And with the clock ticking, he set to work, emptying his life savings into an underground chemistry lab. This is the story of how one father's love collided with the boundaries of science. The blurry line between what we don't know and what we only think we know. This is the story of Xu Wei and the race against Menkes disease. Copper is not optional. It's an essential trace element required for life. Its absence results in death. When copper is consumed, it travels through the gastrointestinal tract, where it's absorbed by the intestine. This step depends on a critical protein, ATP7A. But in Menkes disease, a genetic mutation distorts this protein. You can think of proteins as Lego pieces. Each one is shaped to lock into place. But when a Lego is deformed, it has difficulty connecting to things. And when ATP7A fails, copper has difficulty crossing the intestinal wall. And the same is true when it comes to crossing the blood-brain barrier and getting into neurons. Copper is a cofactor, a trigger that makes dozens of enzymes come alive. Without copper, chemical reactions stall or stop completely. Imagine your body as a factory of synchronized assembly lines. When a conveyor belt fails, parts pile up, pressure builds, and the system starts to collapse. This appears as symptoms like kinky hair, floppy baby syndrome, and seizures. Menkes can be confirmed via genetic testing or testing for low blood copper levels. At this point, you're probably asking, if the body can't absorb copper through the intestine, why not inject it into the blood directly? And that is, in fact, the current treatment. But there's a catch. You can't just inject copper by itself. It must come in the form of copper histidine. But in China, due to COVID, copper histidine was not readily available. Every day, his son got worse. Xu Wei, the man with a high school education, would need to build a chemistry lab and synthesize it himself. Manufacturing pharmaceutical-grade medicine isn't easy. It requires special clean rooms, a team of chemists, lots of money, and it can take years. Xu Wei had an old gym room, YouTube videos, loans, and no time to waste. He translated research papers into Chinese and looked up all the words that he didn't understand. He then manufactured the compound after watching a video of a chemist synthesizing it. He successfully produced copper histidine after only 6 weeks of work. Normally, quality control chemists would use expensive equipment to verify purity. But Xu Wei didn't have time for that. Instead, he injected the substance into rabbits. And when the rabbits didn't die, this cowboy injected it into himself. Upon successfully not dying, he felt it was safe enough to inject it into his child. Blood copper levels improved. He was rewarded with his son's smile. But this wasn't a cure, and he set his sights on something more ambitious. Viruses work by delivering a genetic payload into the cells in your body. But what if we could use that same mechanism, not to spread disease, but to deliver a missing gene? Specifically, a missing copy of ATP7A, the gene that Menkes had damaged. This wasn't science fiction, this was gene therapy. And researchers around the world were already exploring it in labs and clinical trials. Xu Wei didn't have a lab, and he didn't have a team of scientists. But he had something else, attention. And that attention began to attract support from scientists who saw what he was trying to do and offered to help. The next step was clear. He would genetically modify his son.
Thank you.